Hello everybody, this is Angie and I'm here to show you some gift mini albums that I made for Christmas for members of my family. And I had a great deal of fun doing it, and putting together the body of the mini is very, very simple. And after Christmas I will put up a tutorial on how to do it. I just don't have the time right now because we're getting ready to go and visit family for Christmas, but these were the first two that I made. And the cover, easy. I showed this piece in one of my haul videos. But these are ornaments, laser cut ornaments that I got on sale at Michael's. And these are pieces, I think they were called windows, that I got from the dollhouse section of Hobby Lobby. And what I put here to make the door, I spray painted it gold, and this is a little piece of hardware that I got also in the wood section of Hobby Lobby, and these were ornaments, so I decided to make it look like a total door, and I put the little wreath on there, and that's vellum in the background to make it look like a frosted window. And this is, again, a laser cut ornament that I believe I got that at Michael's. And it did have a hole right at the top to hang the ornament, so I decided to put these pearls here. And it worked out fine because it looks like a halo. And these are the first two. And the other two, because I made four of them, the other two were this one and this one. And the same thing, this was a laser cut ornament that I got out of Michael's. I showed this one in a haul video. And again, another window that I put vellum in the background, another knob and a wreath, and a little bit of diamond dust here to make it look like snow. And I really enjoyed making these. They were quite simple to make the bones of it. Took me longer to cover the pockets and do the tags. And I will show you in the second part how I made these and how each of the pages look. So, I will be right back. Okay, I am back, and I'm going to go ahead and review the album that I have almost 99% completed. This is one I'm making for my sister, and I'll just go ahead and start. If you've watched any of my videos, you know I really love glitter, and Christmas is such a joyous time of the year that I've decided to make it very, very happy and very shiny, and I have a lot of dual-sided papers here to make the pockets. And the first thing I did was a tag. I marked it family. I mean, I punched out a little label, mark it family. And there's a little photo in here of a group photo that I have of my family. Kind of rare because we all live in different areas now. We never used to, but I figured that this is an important photo, and I had it done in a wallet size to put on the tag, and I wrote some sentiments on the back. And what I did with these is I want to try and start a tradition in my family. I am not like my other members of my family. I'm not a really good cook. I didn't inherit that gene from my two sisters. But what I am good at is I'm good at baking. I'm good at making candy. So I picked out two of my favorite recipes. And this is my best recipe for pralines. And I typed it specially so it could go on a piece of cardstock, and it would go on the back of a tag. And I put that in the pocket. And I want to ask my family members if they'll share their favorite recipes. And each one of us can put it on our in our album. And this is for Divinity. And Divinity is very, very tricky. It's can be a little rough sometimes to make, especially if you live in a humid climate like we do in the state of Louisiana, but I love making it. I think it's because it's a challenge, I think, too. And then I decorated a lot of different pockets and the tags and cutout tags for her to use. And, oh, this is my favorite almond sugar cookie recipe. And because, of course, sugar cookies have a lot of ingredients and a lot of instructions, I made a tag on a tag for that little recipe. I'm sure they don't need my recipes, but I just wanted to put something in these pockets. And the rest of it is tags for her to be able to put any sentiments, any scripture, poems, whatever she wants to put. and I made a lot of tags for her with the labels. And at the very end, I made this pocket because I wanted to write a special sentiment, some loving words to my sister. And I made this according to the same way as my pocket envelope. I did a tutorial for this, and I call it a CD-DVD envelope tutorial. So if you want to look at that, it's quite easy to make, and you use your scraps. But I will put a sentiment and pop it in there. And these are little seals that I bought in Michael's on sale, and they look like the old-fashioned wax seals, and I really like that look. It's not sealed, of course, but it's like a little flap envelope. And one of the things, and I just wanted to show you one other pocket that I made, and I really enjoyed doing this because it's an optical illusion. It wasn't until I made this pocket on this album that I realized the pocket and tag kind of meshed together. And that's why I had so much fun doing it. It takes a while to decorate all these pockets and put stamps and things like that. But it also becomes quite a challenge. But the tag comes up. But when you put it in, it kind of meshes in with the pocket, and it looks like it's all, well, at least it did with me, okay? It looks like it's all one piece, so it's kind of like an optical illusion. You wonder if the page is torn or it disappears or whatever. So, I mean, that's just a funny aside that I had when I was making it. But I really and truly enjoyed making these albums. And like I said, instead of a Christmas card, I'm making one for each member of my family. And this one is a little bit more old-fashioned because my youngest niece really likes the older-fashioned looks, too. And that is my idea for easy Christmas gifts, and weren't expensive at all because I used my scraps. And for the covers, I used cardboard from the drink cartons. And I think the most expensive part was just buying the ornaments, and they were all a dollar to put on the front. All this together, these bits and pieces, maybe $1.50. I look at ways to put things together and use what I have, and that's what I did for these. And I think it's special when you spend a little bit of time on hand making something for someone you love. And I think putting the pictures in makes it more personal to members of my family. So from my family to yours, I wish you a very wonderful and blessed holiday season, and I wish you all the joy and love of family and friends. And I will put up another video at the beginning of the year. And until then, from me to you, all the blessings of the holiday season. Thank you for watching my video.
You know Dasher and Dancer and Prancer and Vixen, Comet and Cupid and Donner and Blitzen, but do you recall the most famous reindeer of all? Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose, and if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. All of the other reindeer used to laugh and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph join in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you guide my sleigh tonight? Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, you'll go down in history.